All right, yesterday we had the governor of Georgia was on talking about the Major League Baseball pulling out from the All-Star game there in Atlanta and also pulling the draft out, all because Georgia wants to reform their election laws. They actually have. They passed a law. This came about. Nation was watching Georgia in the November election. What did they do? They did what other states are trying to do, fix the problems. But there's something here. If Georgia fixes their election problems, it'll have a domino effect, meaning other states will move forward with their election reform measures. And guess what? I'll let you in on a secret. The left hates it. They don't want that. So corporate titans are being pressured by or voluntarily falling before the left, and they are making their wokeness very evident to Americans. Question is, will it cost them? Joining me now to talk more about this, Ken Blackwell, former mayor of Cincinnati, former secretary of state of Ohio, and now a senior fellow for constitutional governance here at the Family Research Council. Ken, welcome back to the program.
Hey, Tony. It's always good to be with you.
Okay, so you actually have some experience in this because you are a minority owner of a Major League Baseball team. So you've been right front and center, front row seats, if you will, of what's been unfolding in the last few days.
Absolutely. You know, speaking for my home state of Ohio, as someone who spent almost three decades in elected office there, Ohio voting laws focus on election integrity as much as Georgia's new law. And with our voter ID requirements and other safeguards, we would be a prime target for these corporate leaders that are so concerned about being woke that they're just stomping on the necks of their fans and their consumers. And in this case, shareholders in Major League Baseball. And it's just a blatant contradiction. These are the same guys, Tony, the same forces that do business with China, and don't make a peep about that repressive regime in communist China. It is so frustrating. But one of the things that I know is that a wise man once said that a nation of sheep will beget a government of wolves. And what I know about the American people is that we're not going to be led to slaughter. We will push back. And consumers of baseball, fans of baseball, small business owners who will be smacked in the face with this $100 million loss to Georgia and Atlanta, we will speak back. We will hold people accountable for this.
So is there concern among the other Major League Baseball teams that what the league did in Atlanta will have repercussions for them in cities all across America?
I think there's mounting concern. I think the commissioner didn't inform his owners because I don't think that he took the time to take a look at this reform legislation. What he did was that he listened to some loud voices who have a political agenda. It is aligned with this federal push for centralizing, federalizing elections in our country, and this effort, better known now as S1 and HR1, or for the Corrupt Politicians Act, this legislation is designed to actually pull off a major power grab and move us towards one-party control and destroy our 245 history as a free and prosperous constitutional republic. Not perfect, but of the realization that great nations are not the products of great governments, that are products of good people doing things together. And what Lincoln said is that we're not perfect, but we are perfectible, and we've gotten it done, and we have been the freest, the most prosperous, the most diverse constitutional democracy in all of human history.
It's a good point to bring up, because we were discussing this yesterday, because we've got to keep our eye on the ball, if you will, to use a sports metaphor. The real issue here is the elections. It's H.R. 1, S.R. 1. It is this federal power grab that the left is trying to do. And so they're lying. Even the president of the United States is lying. And the Washington Post even called him out for lying. And so they are desperate to stop states from reforming their election laws so that they can say, we've got to blow up the legislative filibuster in the Senate so we can push H.R. 1 through. Now, my question for you, and I'm glad you brought that up, my question for you, Ken Blackwell, is the lackeys in corporate America that are doing the yapping and the barking for the left, what's going to happen to them when the left does control everything? Where do the deltas think they're going to go for support and decrease in regulation? You know, where does the Major League Baseball Association think they're going to go to get help? Where are all these corporations that have relied upon free market conservatives to protect their existence? Where are they going for their shelter?
They're going to go to the ash bin of history, like all of those countries, companies that have tried to survive in totalitarian and authoritarian and government-controlled economies. Aristotle said it best, Tony, there's a dynamic tension between the organized power of the state and individual liberty. That is why the left tries to destroy the family, which is the incubator of liberty, and they try to run God and faith out of the public square, because what they want us to believe is that our human rights are grants from government,
right,
not gifts from God. And look, what I know and what I'm hearing from people all across this country, that they're sick and tired of it, and they're not going to take it anymore. And people realize what Thomas Paine said is true, that those who expect to reap the blessings of freedom must undergo the fatigue of supporting it. And we're ready to put it all on the line.
Yeah.
To use a sports analogy, we're going to leave it all on the field.
That's right. Where this is, well, I'm going to leave it at that sports analogy. I won't go on any further, but I will say this. It is time that, well, let me say it. Everybody needs to be on the field. We're going to clear the benches. Everybody needs to be on the field, because this is these corporations, they respond, although I will say that I think they have in many ways abandoned their fiduciary duty of the shareholders of many of these corporations, and they're taking on a mission that is oriented toward the left. But nonetheless, I think shareholders at some point will say enough is enough if consumers turn away from companies like Coca-Cola, Delta Airlines, and don't go to the baseball games. I mean, the football saw that as an outcome of their political activism.
And basketball, Tony. And let me tell you, Stacey Abrams, she is now saying to these major corporations, what the heck? Because what they are doing, they're draining $100 million out of the economy. And in Atlanta, many of those vendors, many of those small business owners are minorities.
Yeah.
And they are having a devastating impact that is only compounded by the troubles and the setbacks of the pandemic. You know, they own this, and I think they better start trying to figure out how to claw back to some semblance of reality and fiscal responsibility as corporate executives and directors of these major companies.
Well, it as difficult as it is for me, Diet Coke is gone. No more Diet Coke. I have to find an alternative. But look, I'm not gonna give my money to those corporations that are fighting against something that is so fundamental to the preservation of this republic as free and fair elections. And I've looked at the bill. It's 98-99 pages long. The law, I should say. It's been signed into law. Look, this is what states should be doing, and that's the concern of the left. That if Georgia gets by with this without the left exacting a pound of flesh, other states will follow.
You're absolutely right. This is within the framework of the Constitution. What the framers understood was that elections are best managed when they're managed closest to the people where they're actually voting. You have a tighter chain of custody. You, in fact, can check that people are who they claim to be. It just makes common sense.
It does. Absolutely. Ken Blackwell, as always, great to talk with you. Thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you, Tony. God bless.